Hey everyone, welcome to the brand new video lecture series on MATLAB. So let's get started with MATLAB. Let me tell you that MATLAB is basically a matrix laboratory. There are so many literature and so many things available on the MATLAB, so I'm not going to talk too much about pros and cons of MATLAB. Just to give you brief information, and then we are going to start directly with the interface of MATLAB, and we will understand this dashboard of MATLAB. So MATLAB is basically a matrix laboratory. The purpose of MATLAB is to perform engineering and scientific calculations and analysis. So this is the basic purpose of MATLAB, why people are using MATLAB. MATLAB is getting fame across the world more and more. And more people in engineering sector and science sector are preferring to do research and design work through MATLAB. So MATLAB is important software to learn. Basically, MATLAB is developed by MathWorks and it is a proprietary firm, so MATLAB is not an open source available software. See, why people are using more and more MATLAB? Because MATLAB has extensive library of predefined functions, and if someone had worked in some function and there he is applying that function, he is giving this function to MathWork, then MathWork will add that function directly to the MATLAB, and then that function is readily available with the MATLAB, so you can use it easily. You do not need to recreate that function. Another good thing about MATLAB is it can be interfaced with various hardwares like several processor, Arduino, IoT based device, data acquisition card. So there are various devices, various hardwares through which you can connect a MATLAB. And good thing about MATLAB, why people are using MATLAB more and why researchers and developers are going for MATLAB more is because it can reduce engineering design and development time as well as cost. How all these things going to happen, that I'm going to discuss in this series. So stay connected with me in this MATLAB series, and I'm going to explain whatever I know about MATLAB to you, and together we will explore MATLAB more and more without wasting time and discussing too much about MATLAB and its pros and cons. Now let's just quickly jump to the dashboard and let's understand what is the dashboard, what is what into the dashboard of MATLAB. But before moving ahead, there is a quick short question which is displayed on the display. So you need to answer me that question in below comment section before moving ahead. So answer me that question in comment section and then we will move ahead. Okay, so now let's move ahead. The things shown over here is the version of your MATLAB. I am using MATLAB R2016A version. There are various versions available of MATLAB. The list of the version of MATLAB is written in description box. If you are interested to go through that list, you can check out the description box and you can have the list of different versions of MATLAB. Now we are going to discuss about this dashboard of MATLAB. So what thing is known as what, and then after in upcoming sections we are going to use each and everything in this MATLAB. So you can learn everything from scratch to pro in this MATLAB session. The next thing is this. This section is known as the command window. All the commands which you write and all the small programmings which you can do, you can write all that things in this command window. I will show you different examples, but that will be in upcoming sections. The section number 2, this section is known as the workspace. Whatever variable you assign for your script or for the commands, that will be stored in this workspace. So this is section number 2. The section number 3 represents your current folder. It represents the folder in which you are currently working. The next is this. This is the directory. This shows the path of your current folder. The next is this tabs. So this is the home tab, and there are various 3 tabs you can observe: home tab, plot tab, and apps tab. Most of the time we are going to do everything using this home tab. And now we are going to discuss about various sections. And now we are going to discuss about various sections like this in home tab. So let's get started. In last few minutes, you have seen different sections of MATLAB. And now we are going to dive deeply into that. As this is the introductory video, I am going to explain everything in brief. And in upcoming series video, you will know more about that thing, more about that command, more about that particular section. So we'll start with home tab. In home tab, this button is a new script button. When you click this new script button, a new script will pop up, and you can write whatever script you want to write in this section. Let me write a small script for you, a very simple script. X is equal to 10, Y is equal to 17, and Z is equal to X plus. Sorry, my keyboard is not responding as it is too cold here for us. So this is my script, right? If I want to save this script, I'll just go over here, click on save, and I can save this script. See, this is the dialog box popped up. So previously I have told you that this is the current folder. So all the script, whatever I'm going to prepare right now, this section or this script will be stored in this current folder. And the path of this folder is presented over here. So I am giving this as testing. Now I am saving this script. See, the path of my script is different. Where my script has stored is C user Mruduraj and testing.m. If I want to run the script, I just play this run button. This dialog box will pop up because the default folder of the MATLAB is different and the script where I have stored is different. So what I will do, I'll add the path. So I have added the path. The script has already run and I have the answer. X is 10, Y 17, and Z is variable 27. So this is how a new script can be created. All the values will be stored in this workspace. In upcoming videos, we are going to discuss more about workspace and variables. So in this section, I'm not going to explain more and in deep about this section, right? So now what I'm going to do, let me show you something else about this script also. Here there is a arrow button. If you want to maximize this, you can maximize and you can have a good or a complete vision of your program or your script. If you want to go back, you can restore it from here, right? And if you do not want to use this, you can close it from here. So you will be back to your default view. If you want to open some new file, so go and click on new, and these are various types of file you can work with in MATLAB: script, live script, function, various examples, class, figure, app, Simulink model. We are going to discuss about even Simulink model also, but in upcoming videos. If you have prepared any previous files and if you want to open that, you can go and click on this open button. See, previously, just few minutes or a few seconds ago, we have created this testing and it is available over here. So these are the basic things you can do with MATLAB. If you want to find any file, you can click on find and type the name, and MATLAB will find that file for you. If you have two ready-made available scripts and if you want to compare that, then you can select both the scripts over here and the comparison will be created by MATLAB. I have told you initially that with MATLAB you can import data also. So if you want to import any type of data, you have to click on this import data button. Click on that import data button and a separate dialog box will pop up like this. See, these are the various file format which is recognized by MATLAB. These are the various forms of files you can import in MATLAB. So if you want to know more about this thing, just pause this video and go through the list which is presented over here, or else you have the MATLAB, open it and try and have some hands-on practice about this thing. Now let's move ahead. See, over here I have written a script, run it, and some data is stored in workspace. So in future, if I want to use these values of workspace, what I can do is I can save this workspace. Whatever data available in workspace, I can save it as a .mat file, right? So that can be done using this save workspace. New variable, open variable, and clear workspace. That I'm going to discuss in my next video, because that is based on the variables. So at that time it is better to discuss it in detail. So right now we are just having a bit feel of this MATLAB dashboard. From here you can analyze your code, run and time, clear commands, whatever command you have written over here, you can clear it from here, right? This section is for Simulink. If you click on this, a separate GUI based ready-made available functions, switches and so many things will pop up, right? So this is for a simulation purpose. So Simulink is a separate tool of MATLAB on which you can do various types of simulations, right? So now I'm not going deep in this Simulink right now, because in upcoming videos we are going to discuss more about Simulink. So at that time we'll discuss about it. The next is environment, the environment of this display. You can adjust the layout of this dashboard. This is the default layout. If you want to change it, you can go to three column layout, in which current folder, command window and workspace will be these three sections. Even you, if you want only command window, then you can switch it. So these are various various layouts you can go for. Now we are going back to the default layout. So these are the simple or basic things about the home tab. All these things we are not going to discuss now, because these things we are going to use in our upcoming videos, and at that time we are going to discuss about this thing in detail. The next is plot. Whatever script you are writing, right? And if you are plotting something, then you can adjust your plot from here. These are the various types of plots available in MATLAB, and you can choose any of this to fulfill your requirement. Various app support is also given with the MATLAB, and here are the list of various apps that can be supported with the MATLAB. But this section we are not going to touch now. Before ending this video, one very key and important information. MATLAB is like an ocean, right? In this world also there are various types of oceans. So it is not possible to fulfill everybody's requirement using one single video series, because MATLAB covers hydraulics, it covers electrical engineering, it covers digital signal processing. So in this video, my aim is to give you brief about all these things, right? And you can build a basic level of knowledge about MATLAB. And then in upcoming series, we are going to switch to Simulink and start doing simulations using this Simulink tool in MATLAB. So before ending the video, there is a quick question for you on the display. Try to answer the question in comment section below. I'm waiting for your response. At the end of the video, give me any suggestion and tell me if you want to share it with me. If there is nothing, Then bye bye, it is the end of the video.